light it up. Oh my gosh.
I think I like it more than the ACOTAR series. Say hi to Clark.
Oh, I can't.
Hello, friends. My name is Alex, and welcome to a new reading vlog. I am starting off today in my car with you guys because I am out running some errands, and I thought this would just be a good time to let you know what I'm doing and take you along with me on my errands today, as some of them involve going book shopping. As you have probably already seen from the thumbnail and title of this video, what we are reading this week in this reading vlog is Crescent City, House of Earth and Blood by Sarah J Maas. I am really excited and intimidated to be getting into this book. Finally, it is a thick one. It's about 800 pages long, and I have really not a ton of idea what to expect. This vlog will be spoiler free all the way through up until maybe the end. If I decide to give spoilers once I finish the book, I will give a huge spoiler warning in the video. So don't worry, if you've not read this series, you can still watch this vlog. I will not spoil things. I will just give kind of like vague thoughts and reactions as I go through. Right now, I am about 100 pages into the book. I have finished part one. I started it last night, and it is a buddy read with my friend Nicole. So that's a fun little element of this reading vlog. But I finished part one, and obviously we've met our main character, Bryce, who lives in this very intricate urban fantasy world. I am taking the approach of not trying to remember everything and just hoping against hope that I can follow along with the plot, even though I don't fully remember everything about the world and the political structure and all that, because there is so much detail and I don't want to get too hung up on it. I'm buddy reading with my friend who reads really fast, so I'm just, you know, we're just gonna wing it. We're just gonna hope that I remember enough. And if I don't, maybe Nicole can explain things to me. So that is the approach I'm taking. I really don't feel like I understand the world all that well, but we're fine. It's fine. We have about every species and type of fantasy creature you could ever think of in this book. There are so many different like types of characters and political groups and houses, and it is just a lot. So that's where we're at. But our main character, Bryce, is a half fae in her 20s, just living her best life, drinking, partying, doing her job, and then something terrible happens and she becomes a part of this murder investigation. I don't want to give too many details because I do feel like it's a little spoilery. Even in the synopsis of this book is a little spoilery, so I'm not going to give a ton of details, but I have gotten past the point of the like big inciting event of this book, and it was intense. Like, that was a lot. And yeah, that is kind of where I'm at right now. I have met Hunt, who is our other main character. So far, he's my least favorite SJM male lead. We'll see, but that's where we are at with Crescent City. I will definitely keep you updated on my thoughts, reactions, everything as I go. Today, I'm out running some errands. Right now, I'm outside of my local used bookstore because I have recently gone down the Shadowhunters rabbit hole, which I have not been down since I was 16, 17 years old. So about 10 years ago, I read the Mortal Instruments series and the Infernal Devices, and then I never picked them up after that. There have been a bazillion books since then. However, with the Last Hours trilogy finishing up this month, I decided to start listening to the Infernal Devices audiobooks to reread them so that I can read The Last Hours. And oh my freaking gosh, I'm obsessed. So I'm hoping that I can find some Shadowhunter books today, maybe at the used bookstore, or I may hit up Goodwill because that's by Trader Joe's where I also need to go. I am also thinking I may hit up my local indie today, which is also a coffee shop. So I may just stop there and browse and get coffee. I need to get some groceries, but I thought I would make it more fun and bring you guys along, stop and look for some books, and hopefully maybe find some Shadowhunters books to take home with me. So I may intermittently mention Shadowhunters in this video because I'm also reading some of those at the same time. I have myself in a pickle. I am currently reading 4 different fantasy books. I don't know why I've done this to myself. It was a horrible idea. But that's where we're at. That's what we're working with. So I may tell you guys a little bit about the other ones if I decide to continue reading them, or I may just put them on pause while I do this buddy read. We'll just have to see. But anyways, I'm gonna go into the used bookstore and see what I can find, and I will update you guys a little bit later. It is the next day now. It is Sunday, and obviously my book shopping yesterday was not all that successful, but that is all right. Got my grocery shopping done, and I did make it to page 200 of Crescent City, House of Earth and Blood. So I wanted to give a quick update on what I'm thinking so far. I have just gotten to the point where people kind of say is when the plot gets going, and I would agree. I would agree that it's starting to pick up at this point. I'm interested in where this kind of like mystery plot line is going to go, and I absolutely loved the chapter that I just finished, which was chapter 17. Bryce did and said some things that just absolutely cracked me up. She kind of had this little plan that she was keeping secret from some other characters, and it reminded me a little bit of Aelin in Throne of Glass, kind of how she operates. So that was fun, obviously an SJM kind of writing style thing, but I just thought that was cute and fun. I enjoyed that interaction between her and Hunt in that chapter. I thought was really fun. And something else about this world that was revealed in my reading yesterday about the immortals in this world, that if they have a body part cut off, they will regrow it. I just thought that was super weird. There's some things about this world that like kind of crack me up, are just kind of ridiculous and whatever. It is what it is, but I'm really enjoying kind of trying to figure out the mystery, the characters. Of the like kind of 3 POVs that we get so far, I think it's 3. I'm enjoying Rune. I'm really interested in his kind of backstory and some of the things that have been hinted at. I am enjoying him and his story the most, I think, so far, of like him, Bryce, and Hunt. If I'm missing another POV, oops, but those are the ones that I remember. So today I'm hoping to get another 100 pages in. It's already like 3 p.m., but hoping to get my 100 pages in for the day while I do some cleaning and cooking. So it'll be another audiobook. I read a little bit physically when I got home yesterday, but today it'll be another audiobook heavy day as far as getting up to speed for my buddy read with Nicole. So that's my goal and hopefully plans for the day. I have people coming over tomorrow, so gotta get some cleaning done because my house is a little bit of a mess. And I also need to do some editing because I just filmed 2 videos that I'm hoping to get out before this video comes out. So gotta do some editing, some cleaning, and then cooking dinner for my husband. I think I'm gonna, and myself, dinner for my family. And I think I'm gonna make a stir fry. So that's what the plans are for the evening. Maybe take the dog for a walk if I have time. We shall see, but it will be listening to Crescent City, hopefully, while I do all of those things. And I will update you as I continue reading on any more thoughts I have. Sorry, I've not been holding this up. She's heavy, so. Oh well. I'll update you on my thoughts about Crescent City later. Okay, it is Monday now. I am coming at you on my lunch break with a little update. Obviously, I work from home, cozy sweatshirt outfit, but I'm coming to you on my lunch break with a little Crescent City update. I got to page 300 last night, or almost 300. I finished chapter 29, so I'm over a third of the way through this book, and I am taking a pause on it today, so I don't know that I'll be reading anything today, maybe a little bit. My friend who I'm buddy reading with is catching up. She fell behind a little bit, totally fine, because my hold at the library for the audiobook of Clockwork Princess came in, which I think I had already mentioned, my Shadowhunters rabbit hole. That is the third book in the Infernal Devices trilogy, and I have been desperate to listen to it. So that came in. So I'm listening to that today. I will probably listen to the entire thing if I'm able to, but needless to say, I'm taking a pause on this to do that and to let Nicole get caught up to me. So anyways, I will give you an update up to where I'm at, and then tomorrow's update might be non-existent. We'll see. But right now, where I'm at, about 300 pages in, I am really excited about some of the like information that's gotten revealed. Like, to put this vaguely so that I'm not giving spoilers, there was a bit of information that we just got about someone that Bryce helped at some point. And we just found out kind of some information about that situation that was very interesting, very surprising to me. And I am loving the banter between Bryce and Hunt. I was telling you guys earlier that I wasn't totally sure how I felt about either of them. I like Hunt, but it's more their banter that I'm enjoying, more so than like them specifically. I think just for me, he's not my type of guy, but again, their back and forth is freaking hilarious. So I'm really loving that at the moment. I also really love Wahaba. She's so funny. So that's a good little tidbit in there. Yeah, so not any huge updates. I mean, we're getting some more like small reveals, but I'm not quite to that halfway point. So I feel like it'll continue to pick up over the next little bit, but she's a chunky book. So we've still got a lot to get through. I am hoping to get through this by the end of the week, but we will see how that ends up going. Anyways, that is pretty much all I have to share for this update. I will check in with you guys again over the next couple of days. I might try and give you some footage of some things I'm doing, but my life's not all that exciting, to be honest. I'm having some women from my church over tonight to play some games. That'll be fun. And then tomorrow I'm going to meet a friend for dinner. So if I get any shots of that, I will put them in. But otherwise, I will update you either tomorrow or Wednesday, depending on when I pick this back up after finishing Clockwork Princess. So that's the update. You're taking a Shadowhunters pause, and I will get back to Crescent City and you guys very soon. Okay, friends, it is Tuesday, and I am coming to you with a little bit of a reading update, but also an unboxing, because I have some bookish mail that I wanted to open up and share with you. So this first package, I think, is a pre-order gift. So let's open it up and see if I'm correct. Okay, we've got this little thing. I think this is one of the art prints. Oh, okay. This is the pre-order gift for Hellbent by Leigh Bardugo. And it is this like foiled print. Oh, that's not even what I thought it was, but I'm really excited about that. Okay, now the actual books are in this package. So let's dig into it. So I ordered these books like 2 days ago, and I'm really excited that they're already here. I wonder if you can guess what series they might be in based on the things I've been talking about in this vlog. Is that a good hint? We have Chain of Gold, Alexander Clare, and if I can get it out of this box, Chain of Iron by Cassandra Clare. I am super excited. So this morning I finished listening to Clockwork Princess while I was getting ready this morning, and literally like crying while I was trying to do my makeup, because this book just wrecked me. I have actually never cried listening to an audiobook before. I just thought that that format, like, the emotions didn't get me the same way, but Clockwork Princess has proved me wrong. I cried listening to it this morning. It destroyed me. I can't even talk about it. It's so good. So I'm probably also going to order some more Shadowhunter books today from, like, used secondhand, because I need to. I need to keep reading them. This is going to become an obsession, and I'm going to read so many Shadowhunter books this year, probably. It's ridiculous. But the next one's on my list, because I just finished The Infernal Devices. I'm so excited to start The Last Hours, and they're so pretty, and I'm so excited about them. So, ooh, this one's a collector's first edition, it says. I don't even know what that means, but I'm so excited. I don't know if these have, like, art or what makes it a first edition. Who knows? I don't know. But I'm so excited to read them. They're just so pretty. And yeah, really, really looking forward to getting into those. That's my Shadowhunters update. I have been reading, though, also Crescent City. I have no idea how many pages I'm in because I've been listening on audiobook today. I think I'm in, like, chapter 39, maybe? Not gonna lie, I've, like, kind of been tuning out a little bit. I'm so sorry. It's good. It's long. It's long and a little slow. We are getting into more of the meat of what's going on. We have some suspects. They're probably not actually the culprits because I'm, like, halfway through the book. So that would be too fast. But I have been having a blast going back and forth with my friend Nicole about our, like, thoughts and ideas. She's had a lot more, like, theories than I have. I'm just kind of along for the ride, but I have been having fun, like, commenting on the characters, on the relationships, and that aspect has been such a blast. So, honestly, like, not as much relationship development has happened as I was expecting. I like it. I'm a slow burn romance kind of person, so I'm enjoying the pace and, like, that Bryce and Hunt are developing a friendship. I really enjoy that. I'm a big slow burn. I'm a big friends to lovers fan. So for me, the romance aspect is actually really nice so far. Hopefully I continue feeling that way. But yeah, I'm enjoying it. I'm having fun. I am getting, like, a little bit of that, like, middle of the book, come on, let's do something. I'm really surprised they haven't, like, gone anywhere. I don't know. It just, as, like, a Sarah J Maas theme, I just assumed we would, like, go on some sort of adventure, and they really haven't gone anywhere. They're still staying at Bryce's apartment in the city. So that's fine. I'm just, like, surprised by that. But yeah, that's kind of my update for now. I will probably update you tomorrow on Crescent City. I'm not reading any Shadowhunters books right now until I finish Crescent City. So hopefully that will motivate me, because I really want to read these this weekend. It's Tuesday. So I need to finish Crescent City in time to be able to start Chain of Gold this weekend. These are so thick too. So who knows how far I'll get into them, but I can't freaking wait. And I will probably do a reading vlog for those too. If anyone cares about my Shadowhunters journey, making 16-year-old Alex just filled with joy. So reliving those high school days. But anyways, that's all for the update right now. I'll talk to you guys later. Hello, friends. It is now Thursday. Sorry, I did not film anything yesterday. I just didn't want to. That's all. That's the only reason. I just didn't feel like it. So this is my doggy. Come here. Say hi to Clark. yeah, so I didn't film anything, any updates yesterday, because I really just was not feeling it. He's so cute. But I am almost done with Crescent City now. I'm on chapter 77. I think the audiobook, so at the speed I'm listening, I have, like, 2 hours left. And it is getting freaking wild. I have gone through like such a roller coaster of emotions about the different characters, about what's going on. I've had some theories that have like panned out pretty they've been like semi mostly accurate. And I am really, really enjoying it now. I feel really dumb about one of the reveals that just happened. I totally feel like I should have guessed that. But yeah, it's super, super interesting. Now, I am a big fan of Rune still. I still think he's my favorite character. My friend Nicole and I have been going back and forth about how we feel about the characters. We've been sending each other audio messages the whole time we've been reading, and it's been super fun. I've gone through so many emotions about Hunt, and I just don't even know. Again, he's still not my favorite. I still, there was a different love interest at the very beginning of the book. Obsessed with that one. Connor, love him. I have been so, so sad for Bryce and for Hunt and for Rune throughout, different experiences that they've had. There are some definite trigger warnings in this with some experiences that Bryce has had. With bullying especially has been, I think, the most heartbreaking thing to me. It was just the experiences of how people treated her over the past couple of years have just been awful. What other thoughts can I share with you? Yeah, I definitely think once I hit probably 2/3 of the way through the book, that's when things started really blowing up and getting really exciting and interesting. And I wish I had been more interested towards the beginning, because I think I probably would have developed more theories, and that would have been more fun, because I missed so much information at the beginning because it was just such an information overload. So if I had been more interested, it probably would have been more fun trying to figure out what's going on, because for most of the book I was just I have no theories because I'm half understanding what's happening. But oh well, I'm having fun with all the reveals now. I'm definitely excited to find out what else is going to go down, because there is still quite a bit of time left, and I feel like we're getting the big reveals. I paused in the middle of the big reveals and stuff to do this update. So I don't know. I've done hardly any physical reading of it, a couple of chapters towards the beginning I read physically, and I've been just doing audio while I'm running errands and doing stuff around the house. So yeah, I've been enjoying the audiobook. It's been really good. I'm listening to it on really fast speed because I just want so badly to know what's happening. That's where we're at. Rune's my favorite character. Bryce and Hunt are fine, but I don't love them together. I don't really care all that much about their relationship yet. I just have so much sadness for Bryce and her situation and past and the things that she's been through. So yeah, that's where we're at. That's the update on Crescent City. And I will get back to you probably tonight. I will probably finish this book today and end the vlog tonight once I finish reading this book. Chapter 79, and I'm not okay. I'm super not okay. Okay, super quick thoughts right now that I'm having as I'm being slowly
soul crushed by Sarah J Maas is that she freaking chose violence with this series. Like, neither of her other two series had me emotional in the first book. They all, like, took a while to get there, but I guess this one's honking 800 pages. Still, yeah, neither ACOTAR or Throne of Glass was, like, very emotional in book one for me, but Sarah chose violence with Crescent City because this is rough. I'm sad and angry. Sarah, how dare you?
Chapter 90, 50 pages left, and it's getting crazy.
Oh my gosh, I'm listening to while I'm making my dinner. Oh, I don't even know what chapter that was, but light it up. Oh my gosh. Okay, that's all.
End of the book.
Wow, that ending, those last 200 or 300 pages were a ride, and definitely worth it. I really, really enjoyed them. It was not quite as, like, spicy as I expected it to be, which is good. That's, like, for me, that's good. I mean, there were scenes, but not as intense as I expected, so pleased with that. What else can I say that's not spoilery? I feel wrecked. I think I like it more than the ACOTAR series. Probably not as much as, like, the second half of Throne of Glass. But again, this is only one book. I've only read the first one. I do have the second one, but I will probably not read it right away. But I am looking forward to it. There wasn't, like, a super big cliffhanger at the end. And I know there is one at the end of the second one, so I'm like, maybe I'll wait till there's at least information about the third one before I hurt myself by finishing the second one. But, oh my gosh. Yeah, I cared about the characters more than I thought I was going to by the end. Very emotional about a lot of the stuff that went down. Was very action-packed, which was fun. Still really don't give a crap about any of the political stuff. A lot of the world building and, like, it was just a little more than I cared about. Maybe that will get more interesting, but, like, yeah, a lot of the history and, like, classes and stuff was just, like, more intricate and intense than I feel it needed to be. Who knows? That's all I have to say, spoiler free. Hope you enjoyed watching me cry and be gutted by Sarah J Maas with this book. I think I liked it a lot more than I expected to by the end. The first half is rough. Everyone says that, but I enjoyed it. It was good. I'm glad I read it with someone. That was really fun to have Nicole to send thoughts back and forth with. Our string of audio messages to each other is pretty funny. So I definitely would recommend buddy reading it if you haven't read it yet. But yeah, thank you so much for hanging out for this video. I will in a moment do a couple of spoilery thoughts, but before I do that, Thank you so much for being here. If you don't want spoilers, please give this video a like, subscribe if you have not, and get out of here before I start talking about spoilers, because I do not want to spoil this for you. The surprises are so fun. So yes, comment your thoughts, feelings, what you're reading down below, and skedaddle, because we are about to get into some spoilers in 3, 2, 1. Okay, I gave you enough time. If you are still here, this is your own fault if you get spoiled. But please don't, because I really don't think you should be spoiled. I was spoiled like very slightly. Here we go. I'm going to tell you what my spoiler that I knew was. I knew that Bryce was starborn from the beginning. That was one thing that I had, you know, being around the book community, that was the thing that I knew. So that reveal was like not a big deal to me. I was like so touched by the fact that she hid it for Rune. Super sweet. I really enjoyed their bond, and like their healing at the end was precious. So yeah, that was adorable. I, for the almost the entire book, was just mad that Connor was dead, because I liked him more than Hunt. I do. I like a cinnamon roll man. He was really sweet, and Hunt was just not my type of main character man. So I missed Connor a lot. That like scene, that was what I was like crying about at the very end, was Connor waving to her from the bone quarter. And her texting him, "I'm home." I can't. I really thought they were really sweet. The whole thing with like the pack basically viewing her as his mate after she agreed to, yeah, that was rough. I like felt for him, but I also felt for her, and the way that they freaking bullied her was awful. It was horrible. I love Juniper. Thank goodness for Juniper. She's the best. Bahaba, I'm mad about it. I really liked Lahaba, and that freaking crushed me. Her like mantras that she was saying to herself, that like, "I'm gonna save my friends. My friends are here." Oh, I can't. That was too much. Bryce's phone call when she thought she was going to die, the like, "Tell my parents I love them, tell Rune I forgive him." Wow. Oh, Bryce and her mom were freaking awesome. I loved their relationship so much. Yeah, I hope we get more of Ember in the next book, because I really, really liked her and Bryce's relationship a lot. Danica. What freaking happened to her was absolutely atrocious. I cannot. Like, I kind of get her not like giving up her soul, because how could you with that memory of what happened? That it was her, even though she didn't mean to or want to. That was awful. Absolutely horrible. I had kind of figured that out a little bit beforehand, before it was revealed, but like, oh my gosh, the reveal, the like actual reveal from Micah was just devastating. It was devastating that that's what happened to her. Justice for Danica. That was awful. Thank you, Bryce, for destroying Micah and vacuuming him up. You go. That was rad. The whole Danica, like the light it up, that it was really her talking from bone quarter, I freaking could not. Like, that's when I was sobbing in the kitchen making my dinner. And it was not because I was cutting onions. I cut the onions after that clip. So those were real tears. That gutted me. And then her like actually giving up her soul so that Bryce could make the jump back. No words for that at all. The Autumn King is the worst. I mean, not as bad as what's her face? The lady whose Hunt chopped her head off and burned her from the inside out with lightning. It was lots of head chopping by Hunt and Bryce. Not that mad about it, but it was a little graphic. I feel like I'm rambling so much, but I literally just finished. I have so many thoughts. The ending, I have no clue, like, because it ends the epilogue with Aethys, however you say it, the little demon guy, the cat, and Jessica. I don't know what the frick is going on with that. The whole, like, library thing. I have questions. I have a lot of questions, but none of them are, like, crazy burning questions. I'll be okay to wait a little bit for the next book, or to read the next book. But, wow. Yeah, I'm very interested to find out what's gonna happen in the next book. I would really love to see the underwater, like, mare kingdom at some point. I'm really curious about that. I'm wondering if we'll get like an underwater kingdom book. That would be really interesting to me. I think that's all the like rambly thoughts I have for you after finishing this book. I really, really enjoyed it. And I hope that you enjoyed coming on this journey with me and seeing some of my reactions to what was going down in Crescent City, House of Earth and Blood by Sarah J Maas. I will probably vlog the second one. Let me know in the comments if you would like to see a vlog of me reading House of Sky and Breath, and let me know your feelings towards this book. Do you enjoy this as much as Sarah J Maas's other series? I want to know. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. Please like this video, subscribe, all the things if you're feeling it, and I will see you in the next video.